Hello, hello, hello. I'm back again with a new video and a different technique. This is Nipa here from Paper Petals and a very warm welcome to all of you. Today we are going to experiment creating a texture without using texture or modeling paste with this piece of cardboard which came inside the box of a mobile which I had purchased a couple of years back. You can use any piece of cardboard which comes with packaging. So without creating more suspense, let me tell you what we shall be doing today. We are going to do the brick effect. I'm quite excited because it is going to be an experiment for me. I don't know what the outcome is going to be, but I'm hoping that it'll be what I imagine it to be. Keeping fingers crossed, so let's begin. Firstly, we are going to cut this cardboard into small random rectangle pieces. The size need not be the same. It is about, 1 inch wide and 1 centimeter this way. So we're just going to cut a few more pieces like this. And just random cuts. I've already cut a few pieces and kept earlier, and now this is another piece of cardboard which is lying with me, and have just primed it with gesso. This is the gesso that I have used. Now we are just going to glue all these cardboard pieces in the shape of a brick on this. Like so. You can use whatever glue you have at home and start sticking. I will just finish this process so that the video does not get too long, and I'll be back in a moment. So the base is now ready, the cardboard pieces are stuck, and now I'm going to apply a coat of gesso over this. This is the gesso that I'm using. Once you finish applying the gesso, we'll leave it to dry for a while. And then paint the bricks. Okay, the gesso has dried. And now the fun part begins. Coloring of the bricks. So my color palette is going to include a little bit of flesh tint or a yellow or an ochre color, whatever you have. These are all acrylic colors, but you can go ahead with chalk paints, or you can use watercolors, whatever is convenient and whatever is available with you. I'm taking two shades of brown, a light and a dark brown. I don't know whether I'm going to use this color, but I've kept it with me. It's crimson. Maybe, maybe not. We'll see how it progresses and think about using this one. And a little bit of black and white. So this is my color palette. So let's begin the fun part. First, I'm just going to use this flesh color and randomly just color it, leaving bits and pieces of white color to be seen from below. Now I'm just going to give random strokes of brown. Just give some dry strokes without adding any water. darker brown stroke. I'm going to give it a little bit on the spaces between the bricks. I'll use a thinner brush for that. This is the dark brown color that I'm using to color between the bricks. And it's okay if it goes above on the bricks too, not a problem at all. Even if the white is seen from below, bricks are never of the same color, so it's all perfectly fine. My gesso is a little wet below, so you can see the whiteness coming out. I will even use a little bit of black and brown in the spaces in between. There is no fixed rule to coloring. You can color your bricks any color you want. It can be either shades of reds or greens, brick, just like a wall. When you color a wall, you can color it in any color. Bricks also can be colored in any color. I've done a wooden effect on a painting. I'll show you one of the paintings at the end, in which I've made the wood only of brown and white. At the end of the video, I'll show that painting to you. If you feel that at places that it has become a little dark, you can just dip your cloth rag in water and just wipe it a little bit to lighten the color. This we can do because we have applied gesso on it. Now I'm going to add a little bit of touch of crimson just to give it a little brightness. So just giving some random strokes of the crimson here and there. And removing a little bit of color at certain places where I feel it's too dark. And it gives a more natural look when you're doing this, because you'll never achieve this kind of an effect with a brush. So I think more or less it is complete. I'm just going to add a little dash of black in it. So the black I'm going to just add in between at certain places where I feel I want that darkness to be seen. And again, it is all right if it comes on the bricks too. So how do you like it? I hope you all enjoyed the tutorial, and I hope it will be helpful for you all. You can do this on any one of your art projects. It can be on a canvas, a mixed media. You can use this as a base on anything. I had fun doing this tutorial, and it came out better than I expected. So I'm quite satisfied with the entire process. So hope you all enjoyed the video, and as I promised, I was going to show you all the wooden effect that I did with brown and white. So I gave this fence look in brown, white and another shade of brown. Those are the only three colors, and black of course, that I have used in the fence. So here is the final look of our brick effect. Hope you all enjoyed the tutorial. Thank you for watching, and hoping to see you all soon again. Stay home and stay safe. Bye bye.